Oh, that's
it's
one.
That
that's
little bit. Yeah, that little bit. That's a kind of a standard camera. You know.
The uphill S is a lot of cars right here. This is a really fast. There's a little bump right where you crest this hill. So you have to get the car just right, or as you get faster, the car will literally get light on its tires and the car spin around. Turn 10 is a nice blind corner. You can't see where the road goes. So you have to trust that there's a road out here. I'm going to use every bit of it. This is where Oak Tree used to be.
A what?
There used to be a big tree here, and this was called the Oak Tree Corner.
Oh.
So you come through, and the big oak tree set right over there.
Is that what it's still called?
They still call it Oak Tree, yeah. But it's close. Section two, not only because of the corners, you took pictures up here last year. See how the track
right there,
yeah, right over, yeah, all up here.
Yeah.
The way the track, not only are you turning, but you're doing this, and it makes this because anytime the car is bottoming out like it is here, there's more grip. Here, there's not as much grip because you're cresting a hill. Track out a longer path, you can go faster. almost always apex and then track out. Except this corner here in turn four, like we were talking about earlier, there's not room because you immediately, so you want to turn this one, stay sort of in the middle, and then immediately back to the right. Because we're accelerating, because we want to get as much speed as we can for this next straightaway. So if you don't give up a little bit at turn four, it slows you down over here. It's all about giving and taking. You can drive it different ways, but it's about coming out with the best combination. This is again that little bump. It doesn't feel like anything at this speed, but 130 miles an hour, it becomes a jump. So the trick is that when you go over the jump, you want the steering wheel straight. As long as you're going straight, inertia, momentum, you learn about in science, will keep you straight. But if you're turning when you get there, bad things happen. But only at 130 miles an hour or faster. This is a fun corner. This is another decreasing radius. So you enter this corner really fast. Like this corner is really fast. The problem is, if you don't slow down here, you drive straight off the track. Because I have to turn more. There's two of those corners here where you have a... The first part of the corner is really fast. The second part of the corner is really slow. That's a decreasing radius because the radius of the corner gets smaller. It's really two corners. But you drive it as if it's one shrinking corner. This is fun. We're going pretty good at speed. Faster than my airplane would go.
Wait, who was?
Me driving Mr. George's yellow car we used to have. We're driving highway speed now. You want to go that way, you want to go straight for the corner, but by turning in late, and apexing late, it lets you accelerate
and then
go out. If you turn in too early, if you try to accelerate, you drive off the track. So it's all about finding that balance. This is the other decreasing radius. So this, we're turning a little bit,
but
when we get out to the edge of the track, we add more steering input, we accelerate, and the car goes right out the edge. Throwaway, stay a little bit to the left because we're going to accelerate right through here. Right out. Feels like you're going to fall right off the edge of the track. And this is where you start your acceleration for the straightaway. Thank you. thought he was sliding off the track. Either that or they spilled something.
In this corner, you're braking really hard. Braking.
Then as soon as you turn in, you start again.
Squeezing the throttle.
Accelerating for the next straightaway. track was wet.
He just squeezed the throttle just a little bit too much and then